إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ربنا سبحانه وتعالى، Our Lord Allah سبحانه وتعالى، The Creator. He created everything سبحانه وتعالى. إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب. Indeed, in the creation of the heavens and the earth and the alternation of the night and the day are signs for those of understanding. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everything, and we need to understand and to think deeply about these things to increase our faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah created these things for us. أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ سَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ سَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَالْفُلْكَ تَجْرِي فِي الْبَحْرِ بِأَمْرِهِ وَيُمْسِكُ السَّمَاءَ أَنْ تَقَعَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِالنَّاسِ لَرَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. Do you not see that Allah has subjected to you whatever is on the earth and ships which run through the sea by His command, and He restrains the sky from falling upon the earth. How many years the sky doesn't fall on the earth, and we live peacefully between the earth and the sky, because Allah, our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Creator, kept the sky in its place for millions, maybe, or 100 years, Allahu A'lam, many years. إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ, unless by His permission. A time will come, it will be a mess, subhanallah. The mountains will be like the earth and the level, and some mountains will be like the wool, subhanallah, the day of judgment. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now keeping them in their places. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُمْسِكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ أَنْ تَزُولَا وَلَئِنْ زَالَتَا إِنْ أَمْسَكَهُمَا مِنْ أَحَدٍ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. This ayah talks about the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and also His creation. Indeed, Allah holds the heavens and the earth, lest they cease. And if they should cease, no one could hold them in place after Him. Subhanallah, this is the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But where are the person who uses his intellect, his brain, to find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the real, He is the creator and He is the only true God who should be worshipped, subhanahu wa ta'ala? I mean the kuffar. سَنُرِيهِمْ آيَاتِنَا في الأفق وفي أنفسهم حتى يتبين لهم أنه الحق. We will show them our signs. We will show them our signs in the horizons and within themselves until it becomes clear to them that it is the truth. أولم يكفي بربك أنه على كل شيء شهيد. But is it not sufficient concerning your Lord that He is over all things a witness? Subhanallah, many ayat, many signs, and it is wallahi enough for us one sign to believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator and He is the only one who deserves to be worshipped alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us these things: the heavens, the earth, the sun, the moon, the day, the night, the animals, to use them. And if we know
that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us all of these things for us, we should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our life and to increase our health and wealth. وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. And remember, when your Lord proclaimed, if you are grateful, I will surely increase you. Which means in favor and the things that already we have. But if you deny, if you forget, if you don't believe that all of these ni'mah, all of these favors from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is from me, it is from the human beings, from the scientists, what will happen? Indeed, my punishment is severe. Subhanallah. If you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you are grateful, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase you. But if you deny, Allah's his punishment is severe. So those who deny, and this is a kind of disbelief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you cover the facts, when you ignore the facts, you wait the punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this dunya or in the akhirah. وَمَا مَنَعَنَا أَن نُرْسِلَ بِالْآيَاتِ إِلَّا أَن كَذَّبَ بِهَا الْأَوَّلُونَ وَأَتَيْنَا ثَمُودَ النَّاقَةَ مُبْصِرَةً فَظَلَمُوا بِهَا. Then he said subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَا نُرْسِلُ بِالْآيَاتِ إِلَّا تَخْوِيفًا. And nothing has prevented us from sending signs, miracles of the prophets عليهم الصلاة والسلام, except that the former peoples denied them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a miracle with every messenger, or more than one miracle, and they denied these miracles, and I mean signs, the ayat. وَمَا مَنَعَنَا أَن نُرْسِلَ بِالْآيَاتِ إِلَّا أَن كَذَّبَ بِهَا الْأَوَّلُونَ. And one of them, he mentioned subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَآتَيْنَا ثَمُودَ النَّاقَةَ مُبُصِرَةً فَظَلَمُوا بِهَا. And we gave Thamud, people of Salih, alayhi salatu wasalam, the she camel as a visible sign. It is not hidden, clear, visible. And we gave Thamud the she camel as a visible sign, but they wronged her. They killed the naqa, the she camel. And we sent not the signs except as a warning. So these signs, al-ayat, a very strong wind, earthquake, strong rain, diseases, subhanallah, these ayat, we should come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you see like these ayat, because people forget, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to remind people that you return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A saying by one of the great Imam Tabi'in, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, rahimahullah ta'ala, when something happened, like earthquake, shaking of the land, he said, فَإِنَّ هَذَا الرَّجْفَ شَيْءٌ يُعَاتِبُ اللَّهُ بِهِ عِبَادَهِ. This kind of shaking landscape or earthquake, it is kind of a blaming from your Lord. Because we do sins and we forget our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Anas radiallahu ta'ala an said, كانت الريح شديدة إذا هبت عرف ذلك في وجه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Whenever a strong wind blew, an anxiety appeared on the face of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. The fear. Why? Because in one eye Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the people of Hud, yes, alayhi salatu wasalam, his people Ad. فَلَمَّا رَأَوْهُ عَارِضًا مُسْتَقْبِلَ أَوْدِيَتِهِمْ. A time came to them, it was subhanallah, no rain. So when they saw the clouds coming to their place, فَلَمَّا رَأَوْهُ عَارِضًا مُسْتَقْبِلَ أَوْدِيَتِهِمْ قَالُوا هَذَا عَارِضٌ مُمْطِرٌ. This is glad tidings. The rain is coming. They were happy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, بَلْ هُوَ مَا اسْتَعْجَلْتُمْ بِهِ رِيحٌ فِيهَا عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. And when they saw it as a cloud approaching their valleys, they said, this is a cloud bringing us rain. Rather, it is that for which you were impatient, a wind within it, a painful punishment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala killed them by this wind, strong wind, which is called the Dabur. And also something happened during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The same day when his son passed away, Ibrahim radiallahu ta'ala an, the sun eclipse happened. Then the Prophet, some people think this is because of the death of the son of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Some people think this is related. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, إِنَّ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمْرَ آيَتَانِ مِنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ لَا يَنْكَسِفَانِ لِمَوْتِ أَحَدٍ ولا لحياتي ولكن الله عز وجل يخوف بهما عباده. The sun and moon are two signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most high, and they don't become eclipsed for death or birth of anyone. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strikes fear into his slaves through them. When you see something like this ayat, go back to Allah, check your salah, your income from halal or haram, your hijab, your akhlaq, do you visit your parents, do you obey your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala? Think about your akhirah. If you see like this ayat, it is not enough to watch the videos, and wallahi sometimes we send money for them, this is good, important. But what is more important, think about yourself, your sins. Where are you from the Fajr Salah, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha? It is only Jum'ah. It is only Ramadan in the masjid. The masjid is open every day, 5 times open. Some Muslims, as if the masjid is open once a week. Subhanallah, we are not Christians only Sunday. We are Muslims 5 times a day. And also at home, at work you pray. Wake up, brothers, sisters. Until when you are, subhanAllah, busy in your dunya, busy in your this worldly life, you think you work hard to collect money. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned these ayat to remind you, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this can be a punishment. فَكُلًّا أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِهِ فَكُلًّا أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِهِ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِ حَاصِبًا وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَخَذَتْهُ الصَّيْحَةِ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ خَسَفْنَا بِهِ الْأَرْضِ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَغْرَقْنَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the types of punishments. So each we seized for his sin, and among them were those upon whom we sent a storm of stones. And among them were those who were seized by the blast from the sky. And among them were those whom we caused the earth to swallow. And among them were those whom we drowned. وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيَظْلِمَهُمْ وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. Allah, at the end of this ayah, reminds us. He is the wise, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, and Allah would not have wronged them, but it was they who were wronging themselves. Don't blame anyone except yourself. You lost your job? Check your salah. You lost your car? Check your income from halal or haram. Immediately think about your sins. Before, during the time of the companions or the second generation, it was easy for them to know from where the sin came to them. He said, some of the scholars or some of the righteous people say, I know my sin from the behavior of my wife or my animal, subhanallah. Because of what? Because they have very little sins. But nowadays, if we have a problem, we don't know from where this sin. Is it because of my eyes, because of my tongue, because of my hand? I don't know. So we should repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قولوا ما تسمعون واستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده أما بعد. Brothers, sisters, when there are more earthquakes, more diseases, coronavirus, SARS, a storm here, earthquake here, you should make a lot of istighfar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس. Corruption has appeared throughout the land and sea by reason of what the hands of people have earned because of the sins. Don't listen to the scientists who are trying always to explain this scientifically because of the oil, because of the temperature, because of Allah made it clear for us, brothers and sisters, because of your sins, because of our sins. No doubt. Because of our sins. People do sins. I don't mean that every single Muslim is doing the sins day and night. But no doubt. Many Muslims. I'm not talking now about the non-Muslims. Many Muslims don't care about the masjid, the zakah. The Siyam, Ramadan is coming. They don't care. They don't feel. Maybe they hate that Ramadan is coming. The restaurants will be closed in the morning. We cannot drink our coffee in the morning. Subhanallah. What kind of feeling that, brothers and sisters? Are you really a real Muslim? Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ هُوَ الْقَادِرُ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَبْعَثَ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابًا مِنْ فَوْقِكُمْ أَوْ مِنْ تَحْتِ أَرْجُلِكُمْ أَوْ يَلْبِسَكُمْ شِيَعًا وَيُذِيقَ بَعْضَكُمْ بَأْسَ بَعْضٍ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. Say, He is the one able to send upon you affliction from above you. Strong rain, stones, many things we don't know. Punishment, subhanAllah. Or from beneath your feet. Something to swallow the people. This can happen and this happened, subhanAllah. Or يجعلكم شيعة ويذيق بعضكم بأس بعض, to confuse you so you become sects and make you taste the violence of one another. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did recite this ayah, subhanAllah, it was not easy for him. He was reading every part, then he was making dua. قل هو القادر على أن يبعث عليكم عذابا من فوقكم. He said, أعوذ بوجهك, I seek refuge in your face. أو من تحت أرجلكم, from beneath your feet. He stopped and he said, أعوذ بوجهك, I seek refuge in your face. سبحانه وتعالى. أو يلبسكم شيعة ويذيق بعضكم بأس بعض, to make you sects, fighting each other, killing each other. He said, هذه أهون, هذه أيسر, this is easier. Subhanallah. Of course, this is a punishment, but this is easier and less than the punishment from up or from beneath us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, لا تقوم الساعة حتى يقبض العلم وتكثر الزلازل ويتقارب الزمان وتظهر الفتن ويكثر الهرج. He said sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the hour will not be established until knowledge will be taken away. Islamic knowledge, Quran and Sunnah. Earthquakes will be very frequent. Not once a month or once a year. Many earthquakes. It is not only in Turkey or Syria. Here and there. How many earthquakes, subhanAllah? Strong or weak? More and more. until the day of judgment. وتكثر الزلازل ويتقارب الزمان. Time will pass quickly. Afflictions will appear, murders will increase, and money will overflow amongst you. This is one of the signs of the hereafter. So when you see something like that, you should realize the importance. And it is serious. It is not a joke. It is not only a video or to collect some sadaqah for them. You should work hard for that day. Which day? Ya ayyuha an-nas. اتقوا ربكم إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم يوم ترونها تذهل كل مضيعة عما أرضعت وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. Oh mankind, fear your Lord indeed. The convulsion of the final hour is terrible thing. On the day you see it, every nursing mother will be distracted from that child she was nursing, and every pregnant woman will abort her pregnancy, and you will see the people intoxicated. Why they are not intoxicated? But the punishment of Allah is severe. This is like introduction for the day of judgment. And for those who died during this earthquake, no doubt, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forget them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the most generous, Al-Kareem, gives a lot of reward for some people without working, subhanallah, without good deeds. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ash-shuhada' khamsa. Ash-shuhada' khamsa. Al-mat'oon, al-mabtoon, al-ghariq, wa sahib al-hadm, wa shaheed fi sabilillah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there are five types of martyr. And in another hadith, he asked his ummah, he asked his companions, who is the shaheed? Who is the shaheed? What is the definition of shaheed? Immediately they said, the one who was killed in the battlefield, jihad, fighting, to defend Islam, to spread Islam. This is shaheed. He said, إذن شهداء أمتي قليل. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, then if it is only about fighting, then the martyrs will be less in number. Then he mentioned, what are the types of shaheed? Al-mabtoon, al-mat'oon, al-ghariq, sahib al-hadm. Al-mar'a tamut bi-jam'. This is wallahi the mercy of our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. To choose martyrs on bed, they are on bed. Or in the hospital. And he will get the reward of shaheed without fighting. The woman, subhanAllah, during giving birth, if she dies, she's shaheeda. Al-harq, fire. The one who dies in the fire, shaheed. Al-mabtoon, disease, abdominal disease. There is a disease in the stomach. He's shaheed, Allahu Akbar. Al-gharq, the one who dies in the sea, he doesn't know how to swim. He's shaheed, also shaheed. Sahib al-hadm, he's sitting inside the house. A bomb and it came to his house or earthquake. He's shaheed. This is glad tidings for the Muslim ummah that you are getting the reward of shaheed, al-shuhada. So it is, and also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the one who dies in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, also he is shaheed. So we should make dua, brothers, sisters. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase our iman and to protect us and to protect all the Muslims and everywhere. Allahumma aghfir lil-mu'minin wal-mu'minat wal-muslimin wal-muslimat al-ahya'i minhum wal-amwat innaka sami'un qaribun mujibu al-da'wat ya rabbal alameen ihfad ikhwana muslimin fi kulli makan arhamu al-shuhada' ya rabbal alameen najji ikhwanana al-muslimin al-mustad'afin fi kulli makan najji ikhwanana al-ladhina hum tahta al-anqad ya rabbal alameen ردهم إلى أهلهم سالمين غانمين يا رب العالمين اشفي مرضاهم احمي الشباب والبنات من المخدرات ومن الزنا يا رب العالمين وفق ولاة أمورنا لكل خير اجمع أمة الإسلام على التوحيد والسنة يا رب العالمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم طهر قلوبنا من الشقاق والنفاق يا رب العالمين آخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين